Welcome to ENT student for discussion on the outline of buccal mucosa. Buccal mucosa is the mucosal lining of the inner surface of the cheek. Cheek, inner surface, mucosal lining. What is the thickness of the cheek? 1 to 3 centimeters. 1 to 3 centimeters. What is the nerve supply of the cheek? It is supplied by buccal branch of mandibular division, that is 5-3. Mandibular division and buccal branch. Buccal branch of mandibular division. What is it formed by? It is formed bulkily by buccinator muscle. Buccinator muscle. What is the lining epithelium? Because there is no masticatory load, so it is lined by non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. It is stratified squamous epithelium, it is a rugged epithelium, but it is not keratinized like in the posterior wall of the pharynx. There are a lot of minor salivary gland openings all over the cheek. The buccinator muscle forms the core of the most important bulk of the cheek and it is lined by non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. You can see the opening of the parotid duct, okay, parotid duct in the front of this particular lateral to this first or second molar, crown of the second or first molar, there is opening of the stenosis, that is parotid duct. Now if you come, what are the extensions of buccal mucosa? You should say from angle of the mouth, that is oral commissure till the level of your retromolartrigone, anterior part of the retromolartrigone. So from here to here will be the extension of this particular buccal mucosa till this level. This is the extension anterior posteriorly, that is oral commissure angle of the mouth. And superior to inferior, where do you see the extension? It is from the maxillary tuberosity. This is the maxilla bone, is it or not? Maxillary tuberosity till the level of lower jaw, that is distobuccal aspect of third mandibular molar. So maxillary tuberosity will be behind the particular third molar of the upper jaw. This, there is nothing like mandibular tuberosity, but you go behind the third molar in the lower jaw. So that becomes distobuccal aspect of the third mandibular molar. If it is not there, that particular arbitrary position, a line is drawn from maxillary tuberosity to distobuccal aspect of the third molar. This is the superior inferior extension. And what are the extensions as far as this cheek is concerned? This is from the upper gingivolabial, gingivobuccal sulcus. This is the gingivolabial sulcus, this is the gingivobuccal sulcus. Upper gingivobuccal sulcus to lower gingivobuccal sulcus. Lower gingivobuccal sulcus, that is the extension from superior to inferior. And where is it going to drain? It is going to drain into the facial or submandibular nodes. Facial or submandibular nodes. And at the end it is going to drain into the deep cervical nodes. The thickness is 1 to 3 centimeters thickness. So this is the one which you have to say when someone asks about the extensions of the buccal mucosa, the carcinoma. So as you know, alveolo-buccal complex carcinomas are the most common carcinomas in India as far as the oral cavity is concerned. So this is one of the important anatomy which you have to master. Thank you for watching, ENT student.